Welcome to an inside look at research in the forensic sciences at Ontario Tech University. Let's check out some highlights from our undergraduate and graduate programs.
For over a decade, we've built some really strong partnerships and collaborations with our external partners and frontline organizations. In addition to our internal research facilities, we have partnered with local law enforcement agencies and other organizations and institutions such as the Canadian Border Service Agency, the Centre of Forensic Sciences, the Lake Ridge Hospital, and private laboratories such as Wyndham Forensics. These opportunities have helped our students grow.
Our undergraduate and graduate students have access to cutting-edge equipment and indoor and outdoor facilities.
One of our specialized instruments is the gas chromatogram mass spectrometer coupled with the electroantennagram. The GCMS allows us to analyze the chemicals or the compounds that we've collected, and the electroantennagram or EAG allows us to set up a fly preparation. And with our electrodes, we can determine if the fly is responding to any of the compounds that are coming through the GC. This helps us to isolate compounds that are behavior modifying, so essentially attract the fly to the body.
The goal of our research in the program is to make it applicable to casework. We also have specialized areas where we endeavor to advance the knowledge of forensic science and create standards. Two of these areas include Dr. Helene LeBlanc's Entomology and Ecology Research Laboratory and Dr. Teresa Stotesbury's Forensic Chemistry and Materials Laboratory.
In this lab, we're focused on really understanding how soft tissue degrades in the environment. Right now, we're focused on understanding blood degradation. Can we figure out things like the time since deposition of a blood stain, but also how they interact with the environment? Graduate students will take the Applied Forensic Bioscience or the Material Science graduate programs. They have access to cutting-edge facilities using a suite of mass spectrometry, spectroscopy, any type of materials characterization techniques to fully characterize these soft tissues in forensic scenarios. On top of that, our research also looks at building biomaterials to simulate these soft tissues for forensic and research training scenarios. Our group really focuses on blending forensic and analytical chemistry with materials chemistry to help in forensic investigations.
My master's project is focused on the characterization of blood stains. So we use electrochemical methods, rheology, and material characterization to look at blood stains and how they degrade over time and in different environmental conditions.
My honors thesis focused on looking at the volatile organic compounds released from degrading blood stains over time. This was done using SPEME GCMS. The facilities at this university really aided in my research.
We do work in forensic entomology and chemical ecology, so anything that'll help us determine a more accurate postmortem interval, such as analyzing decomposition, the volatile organic compounds that are associated with this decomposition, and isolating specific compounds that are attracting the flies to the decomposing remains. We also have a large number of microscopes to help us with our insect identifications. We have a small insectary where we can rear all of the flies that we use for our research experiments. We are a working forensic lab, so we do forensic entomology casework whenever there's a suspicious death or a case of neglect. We get called upon to help estimate the postmortem interval.
My research looks at factors that affect the decomposition process of vertebrate remains. And so I've done research in the decomposition of human remains in Sydney, Australia, at the Australian Facility for Taphonomic Experimental Research, just looking to see if we can tease out some of those factors that really affect the decomposition process and how that can be applied to casework in the future.
My research is about volatile organic compounds that were emitted off of decomposing pig remains. I looked at a couple of methods of assessing and analyzing the stages of decomposition. I looked at comparing total body scoring as well as the stages of decomposition to the rate of decay and volatile organic compounds.
With specialized laboratory and outdoor facilities, cutting-edge instruments, and a well-rounded goal for all program research, Ontario Tech University's Forensic Science program is one of a kind.